So here we are at the merch table in New York on King Crimson's second day in the venue. And here's Merchandise Supremo Guru. Merchandise Guru, I think we need to call you. Yeah, you look like a guru. Mr. Adrian Holmes.
Hello.
How's it been going, Adrian?
It's been going very well. It's been incredibly busy across all the shows. The range of stuff that we came up with seems to be really... really happy. The fans are loving it and they're buying literally everything, so it's going very busy but very well.
And I think it's probably important to say that thank you, Mr. David Salt, tour manager, waving in the background there. We'll deal with him later. I think it's fair to say that unlike some tours, the merchandise stall is really run by a professional, but also an enthusiast who kind of can give it from the fans' point of view, rather than a pro money-grabbing company.
Very much so. I mean, I basically have my own little independent company called Moriarty, and I work with artists. Stephen Wilson, I've worked with Porcupine Tree, Stephen Solo and Blackfield for about 10 years. Steve Hackett from Genesis I do a lot of work with, and also Mr. Fripp and King Crimson. Because I work independently and not part of a big multinational company, I can sort of approach it from a fan's point of view. So when we're designing the range, I look for what I'd like to see on a merchandise stand, and I make sure the quality is the quality I would expect if I was going to buy it, and try to keep the prices reasonable as well.
Push comes to shove, what's the favourite item of that, you personally, what's your favourite item on this stall?
I'm really pleased, because this was a brainchild of mine, because obviously there's an awful lot of t-shirts out there with Court of the Crimson King on it. This one we've done a little bit differently. We've put the Elements tour dates on the back, but we've also done it on a really sort of cool, sort of subtle grey tile. So that's the one behind me there. That's the one that people had to be convinced about, but the fans are absolutely loving it and buying it in the hundreds.
Fantastic. And generally, fans are pleased with what you have on the table?
I think so. We seem to be sending away lots of happy customers at the end of the night.
Well, whenever I see you, there's always hordes of people around the place for what seems like hours.
It's a good job. I like to be busy.
Just one final question. Have you actually seen a single show on this tour yet?
I have not. I'm hoping to at some point. Occasionally, we hit venues where I'm not allowed to sell, and the venue has a deal where their stuff have to sell it. So we're going to hit one of those soon, so that night I can sit and enjoy the show.
And I don't suppose we can end this without saying that in New York you've had, in Philadelphia, or was it Boston, you had Patricia Fripp helping out?
We had the lovely Fripp indeed, yeah.
Who I think is going to be with us again in Madison.
She is indeed, yes.
And we have also in New York been helping out Hellboy himself, Mr. Tom Redmond.
Tom Redmond over there, who has been a fantastic help. Couldn't have done New York without him.
And looking at Tom, he looks so meek and mild, but you wouldn't realise that this is a nexus of chaos before us, a nexus of hell before us. Have you any words for people out there in DGM Liveland, Mr. Redmond?
No.
You missed an opportunity there. You should have really said, is it time for my break yet?
Can I take my break now?
No, back to work, Tom.